One of the most influential confessions was that of ISIS commander Abu Mansur al-Bahrawi. In March 2019, the Syrian Democratic Forces SDF finally put a stop to ISIS dominance in Baqos. Abu Mansur accepted the proposal of collaborating from the US, and following interrogation in Rojava, he was handed over to US forces and taken to Iraq. Some of what the ISIS commander said in the period in question was reported to the press by Dr. Speckhardt. However, certainly by conscious choice, she presented the things the gang leader had said about Turkey more as allegations or partisan accusations. Abu Mansur was in charge of the border trade and passage, and defined his own role as the ambassador for Turkey. He confesses that he went to Turkey many times to meet with National Intelligence Agency, MIT officers and military authorities about the coordination of matters under his remit, from the treatment of wounded ISIS members to the trade in oil and border control. He says that he was once summoned to Ankara to meet with Erdogan, and that he stayed in the MIT guest house, but that meeting did not ultimately happen. Dr. Speckhardt spoke again on 20th November 2021 about the things ISIS member had told her about Turkey-ISIS relations. She spoke with Aydoğan Vatandaş, an editor with the internet site Flee Turco, and said she was shocked by what the ISIS commander had told her. Dr. Speckhardt, who explained that she had attended NATO's Center of Excellence in Ankara on a number of occasions as a speaker, said she was stunned just after a few minutes of listening to what he had to say about Turkey. I don't know whether an academic acting as a consultant for an intelligence organization can herself be defined as an intelligence officer, but since in the country we live in Turkey, we even define MIT shapers as members of MIT. For this reason, we can say it is no coincidence that she said she was shocked in that last interview. It was a conscious choice of words. In the past, these relations between ISIS and other jihadist groups on the one hand and Turkey on the other were never spoken of with this degree of openness, whereas now there is a talk of an Erdogan regime which wishes to control these gangs with an Islamist mentality whilst concealing the truth. Viewed at from this angle, it is clear that divisions between the West and Turkey are increasing, and that the US and the West in general are changing their minds about the bad choice they made in the beginning, and changing their minds about supporting jihadist constructs like ISIS and the Free Syrian Army. Dr. Speckhardt has a lot to say. I cannot include all of this here. Anyone who wishes can find it on YouTube and follow it there. The fire of resistance in Kobani spread throughout the whole of Rojava with nearly 12,000 martyrs to the cause and nearly 30 war wounded veterans. A very heavy price was paid. The threats remain and are still continuing. For this reason, it is worth everyone listening once more to the thing Dr. Speckhardt had to say. Naturally, read between the lines and in the full awareness and context of the reason for her saying them, you can clearly see how double dealing, hypocrisy and immorality affect state policies. And it is double dealing and hypocrisy which gives Erdogan his carriage.